What it do, YouTube? It's your boy P-E-R-C-C-Y back with my old mic, and today we got another video. I came here in defense of Drake, and no, nigga, not in that type of way. Hop off nuts. But I simply came in here today. I remember where I was. I remember what year it was. I remember what state I was in. I was like, actually, Drake dropped Honestly Never Mind. Niggas, I've never seen so much backlash from somebody that didn't announce an album in the first place. Everybody's like, what is this, Drake? What is this? Washed. This nigga Drake is washed. The album's trash. Everything above. And I got... I'm going to go over Honestly Never Mind. And as we go through the album, I'm going to describe to you and tell you why you niggas is tripping. Before we do that, I thank everybody for attending to this video, watching the video, or clicking on it, period, because it helps me out way more. And from what I've seen, a lot of you are not subscribed. Please do that. Anyway, let's hop into the video. Honestly Never Mind. It came out sometime in June 2022. It was June 2022. And it was a surprise drop. It was definitely a surprise drop. He didn't say nothing about it. No social media, like, he didn't say nothing about it. No social media, like, guess, no hints, no nothing. Oh, you know, usually outlets be like, oh, Drake is about to drop an album. Suspecting to drop an album. No, he just popped out of nowhere. What niggas thought they were getting was a full-on Drake rap album. Tell y'all something. When I first heard the first song on there, I fell in love. The reason I fell in love, most of this album reminded me of 2009 Drake, bro. Throwback Drake, for real. The niggas was like, bro, he don't do this. He got house music. Who says who? Drake, this is house music. These are bangers in the club. God, I need to chop. Oh my god, this is not our club music. By our club music, niggas know what I mean. By stereotype and by default, this is not our club music. Real clubs, this is the banger. These are bangers. Starting off with the first joint. I'm not talking about the intro. I don't remember hearing the intro, actually. Anyway, I'm not playing it. Falling Back came in.
Hey.
You niggas just hate. Really? That GTA 4 club shit.
Finding a way to stay out of the way. Mm-hmm. Holding me back. You're supposed to come right back. Guarding myself while I'm all on display. I know you know all about it. I know deep down you feel the same. How do I feel? I'm still holding my breath for the day that you will see that the effort I make is too.
Bro, you gotta move to it.
How can you say
you realize I ain't stopped moving yet? I remember seeing something. They're like, Drake is wild. He can't even make rap music. Niggas just find anything they don't. But that's social media. If you're involved with social media, you know social media is a bunch of dweebs. Fucking a lot of dick slaps. I'm not gonna sit here. Dance in front of y'all the whole time. You guys get my drip on the first part of the song. That's the first song out after the intro. And he had text go green. It's house music. You niggas can't dance. You niggas don't want to jam. Say that. You niggas don't want to have fun and dance in the club. On top of that, when he dropped this album, why were niggas so mad? I remember watching Reactors 2 when it dropped. Why were niggas so mad that it wasn't usual Drake? It wasn't like he announced it and niggas expected a whole rap album. It's a shitter drop. No, I'm not calling the music shit. A shitter drop is like throwaways. I'm just calling it throwaways. It's a shitter drop. He just threw it out there, bro, on a random day. And all of it is like, he's having fun. He dropped it. out of nowhere. Nigga said, this is not Drake. I can't rock with it. This nigga music suck. I can understand if a nigga was like, oh, I don't rock with it. It's not my type of vibe. That's not what I heard. It was like, what is this? What is this? What you doing for your fans, nigga? Your fans, bro. Fuck you, niggas. And at the end, this came before Certified Lover Boy, right? This came after Certified Lover Boy. At the end of all this house music, this jam music, this music that you can't just sit down and just sit down to. You have to dance because it gets you up like that. It's really just an upbeat. I don't know. It just hit somewhere. He even came out with Sticky. You know, at the time, niggas was doing the little hip shit. Philly niggas. He even had the Philly niggas in the video. What's this shit called? Sticky. Hey, homie hanging on my neck. The bracelet matches a set. This is obviously meant for a crowd, nigga. Back and forth over the net. My mama wish I would have went corporate. She wish I would have went exec. Shit hard. CEO, so the lifestyle she respect. Anyway, I'm not gonna play this. I'm not finna just, you know. But it's ain't that was aimed at a certain crowd. It was a lot of flag on that. Also, to end off one of his best bodies of work for what it was aimed for, in my opinion, he ended it with Jimmy Cooks with 21 Savage. Just to show y'all niggas what's upcoming. This nigga dropped Hurt Loss. And like, I don't think niggas caught on to that. I don't think niggas didn't even point that out when Hurt Loss came out. Hurt Loss is cool. Probably like an 8 out of 10 for me. Jimmy Cooks. Fuck a pigeon hole. I'm a night owl in the, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Something like that. But is that how it go? Is that how it go? Niggas like, bro, he gave y'all a preview of what's gonna happen. If this just a shooter drop. When I drop the album, expect this 14th track right here. I caught on to that the first day. I don't know if niggas caught on to that, but obviously they didn't. Jimmy Cooks was actually hard too. And guess what? He didn't steer us away from nothing. Because Jimmy Cooks is exactly what we got on Hurt Loss. Play the song. I'm going to say something. Is this a clean version? I guess I'll play this clean.
Life is the only thing we need.
God,
they
damn.
Need me to go, but I don't
want to. No, I don't want to hear this. This reminds me of NLE Chopper song off 2K20. Oh my God. Do y'all remember that? It like blurred out everything. Everything. They blurred out everything, nigga. Like, you only heard like three words. I ain't listening to mixtape Pluto.
They need me to go, but I don't want to leave.
Rest only thing I heard was Plutoski.
Fuck a pigeonhole, I'm a night out, it's a different mode. I'ma have to make a pain of six on a pinky toe. Heard you with a shooting guard, just let a nigga know.
Hey, I would have your quest side, not the middle. He's a pussy.
If I let my nigga 21 tell it you a pussy. Spin a block twice like it ain't no word.
The park.
Smack the back side of his head like he barked. OVO for well, we come out when it get dark. Big stepper, he came in a rose, but he left.
Finna stretch up. My favorite owner. What is my favorite owner? I think it'll be Tex Go Green.
If I was in your shoes, I would hate myself. Left all this behind to be with someone else. So, why should I fake it anymore?
Why should I fake it anymore?
Can you take it anymore? This time I am left, can I be wasted anymore?
Is this house music? Will this be house music? This is, nigga, this is a club.
Tesco Green is a little different, don't
it? This reminds me of Thank Me Later, Drake. This reminds me of Thank Me Later, Drake. This.
Yesterday, we were getting high. You were invited. You would have liked it. I know you all too well. I said that we.
Yeah, this is a banger. It's a banger.
There's no way to fight it. You can stay, but shout it, here I go. Should I spend a weekend in Vegas?
Nah, this ain't it. Nah, never mind. I'm sorry, y'all. Oh my God, I'm not playing it right now. Nigga, I'm on. Yo. I'm listening to Thank Me Later soon. Yo, oh my God. I looked up Drake albums, and they showing me fucking Kendrick videos, dude. I love Kendrick the fucking down. I'm just sick of the beat. Like I said, I feel like you guys should go listen to Honestly Nevermind again in a, with a different mindset, rather than thinking of Drake having it as a drop that was announced and to be compared with all his other albums. Look at it as something that can be played in the club or house music. You know what I'm saying? Something you can just party to, because that's what his intentions were. You know what I'm saying? And for what he was aiming for, I feel like this is one of his best bodies of work. Yeah, how you feel in the comments? I'm gonna keep it a buck wherever I see. I'm not the nigga that star shit. I haven't seen. I got a candle going. You know, so blessed. You guys stay up, drink water, keep a pair of batteries in your pocket, because you never know if you need them. AA and AAA. And salute.